Alright guys, video number 4 on learning how to mix if you're a mobile DJ, or mixing for a mobile DJ. I would say the most important part is, unless you're in a club environment and you're a mobile DJ who works in different clubs, then you do probably have to mix, but of course that's depending on if the club requests that. If they don't, then the most important part about mixing for a mobile DJ is probably when you get home at night and you fancy doing a cake for your missus. Because I'll be honest with you, there are still a lot of mobile DJs who will do mixing, but it's not the end of the world. It's not do or die. You don't have to sit there and beat match everything. If you think you do, then I suggest you take up flower arranging. In this video, I'm going to give you a couple of demonstrations of how not to mix, but how still to keep the vibe going. Now, something as well, when I started doing these videos on the web many, many years ago, I started wearing just hats, baseball caps and whatnot, and then the hats became a little bit more wacky and eccentric, till eventually I'm normal. but people remember the wacky hats. In fact, I do get people coming up to me going, I love your hats, why aren't you wearing a hat today, or where are your crazy hats? So people have remembered something about me. Now again, let's take this next further. Look at Deadmau5, big head, big ears. There's a couple of guys out there who wear cassettes on their heads. People remember. So why don't you think of something that makes you stand out from every single other mobile DJ? This is one of the keys, big key. Fair enough, if you're doing a wedding, you do have to be relatively smartly dressed. Suit, if you haven't got a suit, a shirt, maybe a tie, black trousers. You need to be in keeping with the overall look of the night. You don't want to go to a wedding function and turn up in a t-shirt all night and jeans when everyone else is with a full whistle on. Sorry, that's whistle and flute, which is short for swoop. All right, geezer, thank you. Oh, boy, hey, no, sorry, ball and chalk, oi. How's you, Auntie Mabel? Anyway, right, so you need to be dress smart. But at the same time, if you're doing an 18th birthday party or it's a little bit more wacky, then go wacky. Because as soon as you walk behind the decks, people are going to go, oh, I like that. They'll probably like you before you put your first tune on. Now as well, I'm doing a lot of this. I'm moving around a bit. Don't do this. People like to see you move. You are an entertainer. So entertain. Right, so when is a mix not a mix? It's when it's a blend. When is a blend not a blend? It's when you use the microphone. Why do you use the microphone? Because you need to communicate. You need to talk to people. You need to explain to them that you're not an iPod, you are a real person. So, in this video, it's about mixing, a transition between different genres, completely different genres, completely different styles and completely different eras. I'm gonna do this in a couple of ways. First of all, let's play this one here. This, by the way, is David Guetta featuring Tapped Rhea, Just One Last Time. And this one here is Spandau Ballet and Gold. I mean, you know, one's like relatively modern, depends when you're watching this video. You could be watching it 10 years time, which means you'll be saying, God, they're both old tracks. And that's even up. No, if you are watching this in 10 years time, you go, that's old, and it's even older. But at the moment, that one's quite new. This one's old. Right, pay attention. Well, newish, sorry. So. So that's that. And then, what's happened there? Oh, sorry, just something appeared on the camera. It's like a long way over there. And then this is this one. So I can do this transition in many ways. I can use the microphone, I can do some sort of blend. I'm going to give you a couple of examples. So we've got this playing. Right, a sort of a blend. The next one, if you're not happy with doing something like that, then try this. This is where this thing comes in very handy. In fact, This is possibly, for a mobile DJ, yes, one of the most important appliances out there. It's called the microphone. And what it does, it makes you rather louder. And if you have got a very loud voice, you probably won't need, you will need one because it's great to have. So, let's do the same thing. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That's David Guetta. Never knew exactly how to pronounce his name. Was it Guetta, Guetta, Watta? I don't really know. A lot of people have been requesting very, very slow, smoochy music. There are a couple of lovers out there, so guess what? We're going to play this one for you. Okay. It's a Spandau Ballet, beautiful tune, entitled Gold.
Thank you for coming home, sorry that the chairs are...
Okay, now a lot of things happen there. One is that, of course, the track finished. I tried to bring in the other one, but there was almost a transition. There was the mix was me talking. Also, if you listen to a lot of radio stations, you will hear the DJs talking over the music. But what they very, very, very rarely do is talk over the introduction of a track when the vocals start. It's almost like the intro. I forget the exact way they explain it, but you may have the beginning of a track and then the DJ will talk, and then as soon as they finish talking, the vocals come in. Well, that's a bit of an art, but once you get the hang of that, it sounds great because it's almost as though there's always something going on. There's always something talking or whatever in the back, there's some form of voice in the background. And again, when you're a mobile DJ, a lot of mobile DJs out there will do the 3.5 minute thing, and that is, you don't really play full length mixes unless, of course, it's a big dance hit and people want that. What you do find is a mobile DJ will generally play 3.5 minutes, 3.5 minutes, 3.5 minutes. So you haven't really got much time to mess around and go and pee and stuff. Well, hopefully you have. If you haven't, then just... like that. No, we don't really want to do that. Actually, that could look really rude. So you don't want to do that. Sorry. Right. So that's another one. Let me think. Here's another one. Why not use an effect? My goodness, my brain's ticking. Tick, tick. Right, here we go. Tick, boom! Ding, ding, ding. Right. Again, not the best example, but it doesn't matter. It's giving you an example. And also, again, I'm moving, I'm having fun, I'm making use of the area where I am. I'm trying to make this little area seem a bit more interesting, because you're an act. You are an entertainer. Entertain. This is video number 4. Practice and enjoy. Thank you.